Hello everyone, good evening and thank you for joining me in this team meeting today. I felt that there was a very important issue that we have been discussing in the last meeting regarding the performance review system, and I wanted to touch base with you on this. So let me just get to it. Does having a performance review system really benefit our organization? So what we have been increasingly seeing nowadays with our team is that they are deployed in different locations, and they will have to travel at the snap of a hat. Especially this is especially true of the salespeople. This kind of a system does is when the manager is not in contact with his subordinate, there is no way for him to monitor what the subordinate is doing at any point of time. And when this happens, asking him to rate his subordinate at the end of a year or a month doesn't really help serve the purpose of giving a fair evaluation. So under this type of circumstance, just having a manager gauge three or four people who he does not really meet, it's up to him who he can place at which point of the bell curve. And he might just put people at the lower level of the curve just because he has to. So this is one point that goes against having the performance management system. And I feel this is very crucial to our company at this point of time. Another very pressing issue is the level of cohesion in the team at the moment. So a lot of managers across various departments have been mentioning to me how their teammates are into serious cutthroat competition, and they don't really have the feeling of unity or the feeling that they're playing for the same team. So when the level of competition increases, especially when there's this performance management system, using a bell curve, what happens is that they start, this kind of puts them against each other. So rather than helping each other and making the company succeed as a whole, they'll be interested in their own targets and their own performances. And we need to cause a break in this and make sure that they collaborate with each other for the profits and for the betterment of the company as a whole. Okay, so how many of you remember the area sales manager position that was vacant for the past 11 months because we could not find a replacement? Well, this is a direct result of what the performance review system can do. So what really happens is that we fit, 12 different ASMs onto a bell curve, and we chucked out one just because we had to, not because he is the lowest performing one. And ever since then, we have not been able to find a replacement. So what happens is that getting using this review system puts you in a position where you have to search for new talent, and new talent is not really easy to find nowadays. And he was also a person who left, who was forced out, was also having a good rapport with a lot of clients, and we have to forego that. To further strengthen my case, I would also like to mention that companies like Accenture, Adobe, Microsoft are a few of the many 40 plus companies who have done away with the performance review system. So that's another reason why we should do it also, because that is where the industry is moving to, and that is where employees would, kind of atmosphere that employees would like to work in. So what is the alternative to a performance review system? So this is where I propose monthly reviews. And this review that happens every month with the manager and the subordinate should be task-based rather than performance metrics, just to fit them in some part of the bell curve. So if two employees have done the same amount of work, both of them would be appraised equally, and they don't have to be force-fit into a curve which forces one out. So that is my suggestion.